Welcome to Calm in Action. My name is Michael Haig, a technical marketing engineer here at Nutanix. Today we're going to be covering HTTP tasks within Nutanix Calm. If you'd like to follow along, I uploaded the blueprint we'll be covering into my GitHub account. You can find a link in the video description. Once you've selected that, select the JSON and view the raw file, right-click and do a save as. You could also do a wget on the same URL. Now that it's downloaded, let's go ahead and upload the blueprint. So first we'll name the blueprint and provide the project we want to upload the blueprint into. And the very first thing we're going to do is go to the credentials section. Now we don't actually need any credentials for this blueprint. Everything is going to be supplied directly through the HTTP tasks. However, Calm does require a single credential to be specified per blueprint. So we're just going to enter in a dummy cred, so you can enter in any value for that password that you'd like. We'll go ahead and hit back. And next we're going to select the Prism Central service. So you can see it's added as an existing machine with the local host as the IP. So this means we're just going to make calls against the local Prism Central instance. Going to the Create section, we see three different tasks. All of these tasks are HTTP tasks. This allows us to use a simple drop-down editor and field values in order to make REST API calls against any sort of third-party tool. So I'm using Prism Central here as an example, but it could be just as easily something like Ansible or Infoblox. The first thing we have to enter in is the request URL. So I got this from the Prism Central REST API Explorer. We're doing a subnets list call, and we can see the request URL down here. The difference being I replaced the actual IP with an address macro. That way this blueprint is portable and will work on your system as well. Next we see we're doing a post. Later we'll see a get and a delete. The response body for this particular call works well with an empty dictionary, so we see that here. And next for the content type, we can tell that it is an application JSON from our third-party tool. Should give you that sort of information as far as what is required. So the connection timeout, feel free to modify depending on your third-party tool. And for the authentication, and we're going to be doing basic authentication here. So this is our Prism Central password. If you're following along, you'll need to enter in this password for each of the four tasks that we're going to cover throughout this blueprint. The next important sections near the bottom are a couple of things. One, any headers that you might require, you can enter in both the key and the value. Nothing is required for this particular call. However, many third-party tools do require a set of headers and their values. The next section is overriding the default response codes. So by default, Calm will use the standard HTTP rules as far as a 200 being a success or a 400 being a failure. However, you can override those if necessary. And the last part is setting variables based on the response. So for this particular call, we can copy the response body and enter it into a tool like jsonpath.com. So if we paste that in, we can get some information about how we can use the appropriate syntax to extract the variable. So what we're going to need to find is this cluster reference field. So we see that the cluster reference field is part of status and entities. So first let's do a dot entities. We should see the field on the right side get trimmed down. Next, notice the entities is an array. So let's do the first instance of this array. And then next up is status. At the bottom of the status, we see cluster reference. So we're going to need both name and UUID. Let's start with the dot name, and we see we successfully parsed out the value we need for this variable. We can copy this, and we don't actually have to paste it in here because I've already done the work for you, but I wanted to do a demo and show how it's possible to modify and manipulate the response data. So next up, we have the create subnet. This is again doing another post. This time though, we're actually sending a larger body with all the needed fields to create a subnet on this particular Nutanix cluster. It is relying on a VLAN ID macro, which we'll see when we go to launch this blueprint. The rest of the fields should look pretty familiar. Again, we do need to enter in this password. And for the variable section, we are setting it as the subnet UUID in the response. That allows us then, under our git call, to use that subnet UUID in the URL itself. We see here it's a git, and other fields are pretty much the same. Again, we can change this over to our Prism Central password. And that's everything for the create action. So when we launch this blueprint, based on the VLAN we provide, we'll make some API calls into Prism Central and create a new VM network. On the delete section, we need to clean that network up when we go to delete this application. So we are using a similar request URL with the address and utilizing that subnet UUID variable we just saw. And we're doing a delete instead in the request method. We don't actually have to have any request body. When in doubt, reference the documentation of your third-party tool. So if we go to the delete section here, we see that we have to paste in the UUID, which helps us build that URL, but we don't actually have a body. Therefore, we don't have to enter in a body on Calm. The other fields are going to be the same as we've seen now. And obviously, we don't need to set any variables as we're just cleaning things up now. So that's everything with the blueprint. We can go ahead and save the blueprint. We'll launch it. I'm going to leave the VLAN ID as 999, but feel free to change that on your system. We'll hit create. And this is going to take just a couple minutes to provision. It's pretty quick, but I'm going to go ahead and fast forward the video at this point. So now that our Calm application is running, we can go ahead and go to our VM list and view our network config, and we'll see we have this VLAN 999 successfully created. Back in Calm, we can go to the audit page, view the create action, and see that the response from all of our calls. We can see the response body on our first call. And we can see the bottom, all of the variables that we set, that we went through earlier. We can also see that we successfully created the subnet. We get an output of the response body, and we see the subnet UUID variable that was set. Lastly, we see the git subnet. This again was really just to validate that we successfully created a new subnet on the Prism interface. And again, we verified that within Prism itself. So now we can go ahead and run the delete action. We'll kick that off. If we go back to our VM list section and select the network config, we can see that VLAN 999 is no longer in the output. Going back to Calm, we can go to the audit section. And we can see in the PC delete section that we successfully deleted the subnet. We can see the response body, and we see the status code 202. So that's how, with Nutanix Calm and the HTTP tasks, you can use simple drop-down fields to interact with any third-party tool that has a publicly available REST API. Thanks for your time today.